Hi everyone, I'm Elzahh and today I'm going to be unboxing the November Fairyloot box. So the Fairyloot box is created by the lovely Anissa and I've been getting a few of her boxes. Really love what she has in them and her themes she chooses and just the things she puts together. She does a fantastic job with these boxes. It is so worth it. It is a bit pricey, especially for international people, but I have to say it's so worth a hardback book. Either it's going to be signed or you get a signed book plate or some variation, and you get a lot of cool stuff in these boxes. It's just so magical to open these up whenever I get a Fairyloot box. I'm so looking forward to seeing what's in this one. So let's get into it. So as usual, I have the link for Fairyloot down below so you can check them out, and I also have links to any of the items that belong to stores so you can have a look and buy them yourself or have a look at the other items in those stores. So they've actually redesigned these boxes. So she's got a bigger box and there's actually like a quote inside the box, and from what I've heard it's supposed to be Thumbelina infused with Fairyloot, so it's cool. I used to love the story of Thumbelina when I was a kid. I used to have a cartoon movie of it and I watched it obsessively. I absolutely loved it, so this little snippet here is really cute and I like the touch to it. But there's still actually the quote from Neil Gaiman that says, "Fairy tales are more than true, not because they tell us that dragons exist, but because they tell us that dragons can be beaten." I love it, it's cute, it's a lovely little quote. So first up we have the information card at the top, and it's a really pretty picture this time around. So pretty. And the box was Royals and Rogues, so that's the theme of this box. But I'm not gonna look at this because it's gonna spoil what's in the box, so let's put that aside. First up we have the little worms that people are annoyed about, but I honestly don't mind. So I'm going to just lift them up and move them to the side for the moment. First thing I see here is a box that was inside the box. And it rattles. I probably shouldn't do that because it feels like it might be breakable. But let's have a look what's in it. Probably a mug. It's a good size for a mug. And it is a mug! I love mugs! I am so excited, it's just a mug. Alright, we have... Ooh, that's pretty. You can see that. It says Queen of Books. Oh my gosh, that is so pretty, and it has it on both sides. Ah, I love it. This is such a nice mug. So this is gonna go in my collection. It's actually gonna go up here. If I can get it up here. So it's up on the shelf. I'll find a better spot for it afterwards. Next thing we have in the box is a bag of tea. And it's from the Tea Leaf Company. And it's called Royals and Rogues Earl Grey Tea. That's cute. I like the picture. You can see that. Can't really smell it, but I don't want to open it because I don't want to ruin what's inside and get a mess of it. But yeah, I got some tea with it. That's nice. A mug and some tea. I'm liking it so far. I enjoy my tea. Next we have here is, I'm not sure what this is. I don't know what it is. I've never seen this before. But it's glittery and kind of waxy too. Kind of looks like a gemstone. Not quite sure what it is. Got a slight fragrance coming from it. Could be a bath bomb, could be soap. I don't know, it's pretty unusual looking bath bomb. Next thing we have is a little notepad. And if you can see, it says Queen of Terrison. Oh, this is so pretty. It has antlers and like vines and swords and arrows and it's Throne of Glass related and it's so gorgeous. I love it. I absolutely love it. And I think it's just, yeah, it's all the same all the way through, but hey, I love it. That is so cool. I love stationery, so I probably will never use it. It will just be a decorative thing, but this is really cute. I like that. Next thing in the box we have is something from Bookworm Boutique. Ooh! Designed exclusively for Fairyloot. And it says, "My queen is without limitations, boundless in all that she does." By Renee Adaha. I'm not even gonna try and repronounce that, no way. Sorry if I butchered it. And it's a quote from The Wrath of the Dawn. A book I have yet to read, but that's cool. It's a little compact mirror. It's quite a big one as well. So that's gonna be in addition to my makeup bag, even though I don't really carry around much in my makeup bag. But hey, accessories are cute. We have a card for the Tea Leaf Company. It the little discount card with a little code so you can get 15% off. So that's pretty cool. Next is Tea Leaf Company 10 tea filter bags. Ah, that's cute. Perfect for the pot. So you put the loose tea, which is in the bag here, inside one of these little bags and you use it to brew with, which is pretty cool because I don't have a tea leaf strainer or anything like that to put loose teas in. So I usually just have to leave it there and then try and strain it to another cup with a strainer, which is really awkward and it doesn't help because you still get big chunky bits in it. But hey, these are going to come in handy. I should really get a strainer at some point. Really should. Next we have is a tote bag. It says that I will bow before no one and nothing but my crown. Ooh, and it's a quote from A Court of Mist and Fury. I'm pretty sure it's what Rhysand says to Feyre at some point. But that is such a gorgeous bag, and I have a feeling that it's designed by somebody that I know of. I just don't want to say it yet because I feel like if I say it, I'll probably get it wrong, but I'll leave that there to decide. Oh, we have some prints up next. The first print I have here is one from Ryan Grodens? I don't know. It says, once upon a different time, there was a girl who lived in a kingdom of death. And, oh, I can't remember what the book was that this is from. I think it's by Wolf by Wolf, if I'm correct. And that is so cool. I love that design. It's so pretty. But it doesn't say who it's by, so I'll have to have a look at the card for that afterwards. Next one we have here is from Red Queen. It's a quote from Red Queen that says, "Rise as red as the dawn" by Victoria Aveyard. That's pretty there. It has like a crown and a ribbon with blood dripping from it. Ooh. And then it's double-sided, so on the back of it, it has a picture of the character with lightning and a crown. And for some reason, I can't remember the character's name, so forgive me. But I do love the series. I really do. I love the second book more than the first book, but I really enjoyed the series. I can't wait for the next one. So next we have is the Fairyloot bag, and inside is the book and probably some bookish content. So let's have a look what's inside. I love these little Fairyloot bags. They make great little portable bags for your books when you're out and about. First thing I see is the Fairyloot reading buddy card with the hashtag number so I can find my reading buddy online. Next is a design of some merman, I think it is, or a fish, I don't know, some kind of creature-ish. Kind of a creepy creature, isn't it? But yeah, I'm gonna call it a merman. Next is a signed book plate, and I know what the book is. So I'll show you the book first. The book is, oops, nearly dropped that. So the book that came in the box is Nemesis by Anna Banks, and I don't know much about this book, but that's the book that came in the box. It also came with a signed book plate to go in the book, and it also came with a bookmark to go with the book. So that's cool. And we've also got a note from the author about the book, which is actually really cool how she's done that. We just appreciate the effort. That is so cool. And the last thing that was in the bag is the Fairy Scoop little mini mag pamphlet that they introduced now. And it has an interview with the author, like they did with the previous box that I got. You have a little bit of information about the author. And we have some what next to read, some recommendations at the bottom, which of course includes The Wrath and the Dawn there, The Reader by Tracy Chi, and A Shadow Bright and Burning by Jessica Clues, which I've read and I really liked. If you like 18th century and magic and everything, try that one. It's actually really good. On the back of this little pamphlet, it has book bag uses. So it tells you what you can use the book bag for. You can use it to keep your book safe, store and sort bookish swag, makeup and food travel bag. So it's a useful little tips that you can do with your bag. And it says at the bottom, happy reading. We hope you enjoy this box as much as we enjoy putting them together. So I love this Fairyloot box. It's so cool. It has so many cool stuff. I mean, I got a cool mug and I got some tea, some cool bookish things as well. So now I'm going to read you the back of Nemesis so we know more about it and so I can find out more about it because I don't know what this book's about. The king is her nemesis. Can she trust him and her growing feelings for him? Ooh. And, ooh, Anna Banks actually wrote the Serena legacy, the of Poseidon, of Triton, and of Neptune. Ooh, I wanted to actually read those years ago when I heard about them, but I never got around to it. And she's actually written this one as well, so that's pretty cool. Princess Sephora of Cerubel. Man, they have to make words so hard to pronounce, don't they? Anyway, it says Princess Sephora of Cerubel is the last forger in five kingdoms. The spectorium she creates provides energy for all, but now her father has found a way to weaponize it, and his intentions to incite war force her to flee his grasp. She escapes across enemy lines into the kingdom of Theria. But her plans to hide are thwarted when she is captured and placed in the young king's servitude. Ooh. Tarik has just taken over rulership of Thoria. This is gonna be so bad. Not the book, just me trying to read the weird names and things, okay? I'm so bad at this. Tarik has just taken over rulership of Thoria and must now face a new plague sweeping through his kingdom that is killing his citizens. The last thing he needs is a troublesome servant vying for his attention. But Mistress Sephora will not be ignored. When the two finally meet face to face, they form an unlikely bond that complicates life in ways neither of them have ever imagined. Sephora's gift may be able to save Tarik's kingdom, but should she risk exposing herself and her growing feelings for her nemesis? Ooh! I like that, although her face is a little creepy. I can't wait to read it. Sounds cool. I think I might enjoy this one. I mean, box does say royals and rogues, so I think I'm gonna really enjoy this one. Alrighty, so it's time to read the information card. And this is the first item in this box is the Queen of Books mug, and that was designed exclusively for you by Read at Mdnight. So Read at Mdnight designed it. I'll find the link, it'll be down below. And like I said before, the tea is from the Tea Leaf Company, as well as the tea bag filters. So that's cool, really handy. The little pocket mirror is by Bookworm Boutique, which is what I said before. Queen of Terrace and Notepad is by Alexis Lampley, and it's exclusive to this box and inspired by the Throne of Glass series. Of course, next we have is a scented spectrum soap crystals. Oh my gosh, it's a soap. Okay, we made for you by Crafty Ragamuffin. I like the name. Crafty Ragamuffin. Okay, that's who designed it. So it's a soap. You understand what it symbolizes after you read this month's book. So the crystal soap is something to do with the book. That's cool. It's a soap. So it's not a bath bomb at least. It's a soap. That's cool. Next thing it says, we partnered up with two very talented artists to bring you the double-sided print art inspired by Red Queen. Both designs are exclusive. The lettering side is by Lovely Owls Books, and the illustration is by the Bookotter. Ooh, I follow the Bookotter on Instagram, and she has so many cool pictures and so many cool designs that she makes. Book of the month is the first in a new high fantasy series. The story is set in an exotic kingdom, and it's full of mythical creatures and magic. Nemesis by Anna Banks has the perfect amount of magic, mystery, romance, and action. We hope you enjoy the signed book plate, bookmark, author, letter, and Parani sketch. Parani. Yeah, Parani sketch. That's what it is. I thought it was a merman. So that's cool. I love this box, everything in it. I'm gonna try and see if I can hold them all, which is probably not going to happen, but we'll see anyway. I'm not going to pick up that mug because it's already up on my shelf, so that can stay there. Okay, I've got everything in my hands, and I've got the mug up there. I'm not even going to try to tip that, but there we go. That's everything that I got in this box, including the multiple prints, and the book plate is somewhere there, and yeah. She always has heaps of cool stuff in these boxes. I love the Fairyloot boxes. I'm probably going to be a long time buyer for the future. So cool. So if you want to know more information, it's all down below. Check it out. Also, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Just check out my social links down below. Also, check out the links down below for the stores that are included in this box, and look up the book as well if you want more information about it. Don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more future videos, and that's all. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys have a great week, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.